Welcome to Sports Tonight, Frank. Tell us exactly what's going down tomorrow, Edo State Football Association Awards Night.
Thank you so much, Toyin. Of course, we are back again. This time last year, it was the first Edo FA Football Award Night. I can tell that we are set for the second edition, and tomorrow evening is the D-Day right here in Benin City. As I speak with you now, all plans for the award night have been set. The awardees have been contacted. The guests are ready just for us to roll 6 o'clock tomorrow morning at the Excalibur Hotel. Of course, the special guest of honor is the executive governor of Edo State. You know, we're talking about His Excellency, you know, Governor Obaseki, who is definitely is also our grand patron. The investor will also be done tomorrow evening. We have so many awardees. Of course, the footballer of the year is Isaac Success of Watford FC. Of course, we also have the home base footballer of the year, Osas Okoro, who plays for Rangers International of Enugu. Then talking about other players, you know, outstanding players of our time, you have Bright Omokaro, you have Humphrey Edobo, Samuel Zogula, we have Friday Laho, Francis Monidafe, and Sunday Boygbe. Of course, we also have our colleagues, Duru Hazuagbe of this day, Cecilia Morogbe of Channels Television, Ben Ogbomudia of the Nation newspaper, and Agbonlaho Efosa. They will be honored as media persons of the year. And the biggest of all is the outstanding media personality of the year, talking about Mr. Frank Momo of Front Group. So that is just the rundown. We're also going to be honoring the coaches, Samson Siasia, you know, who definitely was the only team that won medal in the last Olympics in Rio. And we also have Felix Awogu, the GM of Super Sports. Both of them will be honored as football personalities of the year. The deputy governor of Edo State, you know, Right Honorable Felix Shaibu, will also be honored as the grassroots football personality of the year. So you can see that there is a whole lot of package, and everybody is looking forward to tomorrow evening for the biggest award night, you know, of the state.
Frank Laboya, we must commend you for what you've been able to do since you became the chairman of the Edo State Football Association. We wish you all the best with the award ceremony tomorrow, and we pray for more powers to your elbows so that you can continue to uplift football, not just in Edo State, but in Nigeria as a whole. Thank you for speaking to us on Sports Tonight, Frank.
Thank you very much, Tony, for having me on the show.
All right. So that's Frank Laboya, Chairman, Edo State Football Association, speaking to us about the Edo Football Awards that will be taking place tomorrow. Of interest to me, don't say I'm partisan, Cecilia Morogwe. That's good. It's not just about the guys. That's the issue that the Falcons were not happy about. It's not just about the guys. We have to recognize
spread the love.
You have to recognize the women, and I think it's honor well deserved for Cecilia.
Yeah. I think so. I can't agree less.
I'm sure the Falcons will be celebrating that as well. All right, guys, let's put a peg on what we're talking about. The long term really for funding is private sector participation.
Yeah.
There is no way government alone can fund sports with all the projects that government is involved in and make a success of it. Elsewhere, the private sector play a major role in sports funding. And I was saying something the other day, Haruna Quadri has become Africa's first ever Olympic quarterfinalist. Any corporate body identifying with him? The corporate bodies in Nigeria need to do a lot more. They need to do a lot more.
They can cash in on it, you know. There's a whole lot of
is in the top 25 in the world, for example, because some people say because we don't have heroes, that's why corporate bodies are not coming around.
That's not true.
There are two ways to it. Do you want to identify with those who are already made, or you want to help partner to raise stars? I think it's more sustainable if you partner to raise stars.
So there's also a problem in here. Private sector also wants accountability. How many of our sports federation can be accountable?
But how do you know?
See, SAPA declared a 40 million rand loss 2 days ago. It's a loss, but there's accountability. Let me give you another one. Private sector also wants to abstain from controversy. The NFF has always enmeshed itself in controversy about the leadership also. Do you think private sector wants to do business with the NFF with all of that?
Which is one of the challenges that the present administration of the NFF have had to grapple with.
See, that has been a huge factor.
I've been aware of some corporate deals that were on the table about to be signed off when there will be a pronouncement, a court case, and a dissolution, these things. You know, it's a ripple effect. One thing leads to the other one. So we really need to get the foundation right, because when there are no tussles, when you have done things according to the laid down rules and regulations, you don't have issues like that. So it's something that rubs off.
I think, you know, we can say all we like about corporate bodies. I don't think they are shy to bring the money. The problem with sports, while you guys are talking, I'm just trying to understand the problem as well. Is it the scandals? Is it the lack of accountability? Because if you look at the entertainment sector, I mean, they're calling the shots. They're putting the money in. But when it comes to sports, you can accuse people of neglecting Nigeria and Nigerians and probably take the money to sponsor things outside of this country, things that Nigerians will not directly benefit from. But if they can do that in the entertainment sector, it means that if we get our acts right, if, for instance, that issue of accountability, if we can sort it out, be open, be transparent, then of course some of these corporate bodies want to, put funds on the table.
Okay, we still have basketball coming up on sports tonight. Let's pause for a break, a timeout, take you to the FIBA Africa Champions Cup for men. Canopilas losing out to El Hali in the semifinals, and then Femi Adefeso will be joining us for the rest of the show. Yemi will take a walk, but Femi will be back with us.